Managing Director Bill Beta was on CNBC this week, and he has a lot to say about the value of investing hundreds of millions of dollars into Bitcoin and into cryptocurrency. He sees it not as just a single business solution, but as an economy. He sees the value investing hundreds of millions, and he has, as he will share with you, he has four different teams in Comcast Ventures that deal with digital currency, cryptocurrency, Bitcoin, because they see the value in this. They know it's volatile, but they see it as the pregame. So we are not even at the first inning of a baseball game or the first quarter of a football game. It's actually the pregame. So this is huge news. This is huge potential. If you believe in cryptocurrency or Bitcoin or you want to be a part of it, if now is not the time, I don't know when will be the time for you to actually see the value and the potential that it has, because you're at the seed level. You're in the soil. The seed hasn't even been planted yet. It's being planted now. So we have this potential to explode with whatever investment you decide to make or whatever token or how much Bitcoin you want to hold. So there are a lot of opportunities, and I'll share with you more at the end of this video how you can be a part of it. But now let's listen to Bill on CNBC because he talks all about the potential of this Bitcoin bull market, of how hundreds of millions of dollars is being pulled into these ICOs, these new coins, these new economies. He talks about the economy of it, not just the business solution. This is important to understand, of how these big players with big money, hundreds of millions to billions of dollars, are utilizing their investments to grow it. And this is something that you can be a part of as well. So go ahead and tune in to the CNBC really quick. Bill from Comcast Ventures is bullish on Bitcoin, and here is what he has to say.
We're very excited about cryptocurrency and blockchain. Irrespective of the price of Bitcoin, unfortunately, if it's at $10,000 or $10, we still think that there's core technology there that has the potential to disrupt many industries. I think people are realizing that Bitcoin, blockchain, there's real value there. Right? If you look at the three main principles of blockchain around identity, around this immutable ledger, so the ledger of all the transactions, and then this decentralized control mechanism there, it has the potential to disrupt existing players, social media, content distribution, e-commerce. If we look at Internet 1.0, if you will, the internet of the 90s and early 2000s was about how do we connect people, but it didn't solve the trust problem. So we formed these aggregators that would connect buyers and sellers together, and these aggregators would reap the profits. Now with blockchain technology, that's not necessary. Buyers and sellers can connect to each other in a trusted fashion without a central player. So I think there are a lot of new business models that we haven't even seen yet develop. Some folks have said that we're in early innings. I think we're more like in the pregame. If you've ever been to a football game and you see folks in the parking lot with the barbecues, drinking and all, I think we're more at that phase where the rules of the game haven't been established yet. The team players are not there. Still basic infrastructure around the technology hasn't arrived yet. So I think it may be a year or two before we start to see folks move from replicating existing social networks, e-commerce players, content distribution, taking existing models and applying it to blockchain, to then doing things that weren't even possible and inventing new applications, killer applications. I think I haven't seen that yet, otherwise I would have invested in it, but I think it's going to be a little while. We have four partners at the firm who are focused on blockchain as part of their work. So we're looking at it from technology point of view, BDP Enterprise, which is what I'm working on. We have another partner that's looking at digital media, another at consumer. So we're taking it seriously. We're going to continue investing out of the main fund and look for opportunities. One thing we're still having a little bit of problem with is on valuations. So we're seeing a lot of these ICOs that are valuing these companies at the hundreds of millions, and all they have is some, a great team and a nice white paper, but that's it. We're happy to pay $100 million valuations for companies that have a real product, some real customers, some real traction, some revenue as well. So we're trying to figure out, how does venture play in this new world where we have initial coin offerings, token-based economies, and trying to figure out, how do we value these companies? Because these valuations are more like valuing an economy than valuing a business. And so what does that mean when you're investing in an economy that are going to have multiple players and multiple businesses that might be built on top of that protocol?
Robyn Linn here, Zenabits. If this isn't something that moves you and motivates you to get more Bitcoin, I don't know what will be more inspiring for you to understand that you actually have the potential to generate more Bitcoin and hold more crypto. So if you want to learn more about how to generate crypto commissions where you don't have to buy more of it, but you can hold more of it and generate commissions through crypto in a non-cheesy, non-hypey way, then I have the solution for you. If you click the link below this video, it will take you to a page to learn more. And I want to share with you more videos on how you can start generating crypto commissions without having to buy more Bitcoin. This is for those of you who want to go big, and you know that this is something that excites you. Just like all of these venture capitalists are talking about, you now have the opportunity to grow your Bitcoin. I'm Robyn Linn. Click the link below, and I'll meet you on the next